Hello everybody, and welcome to the extras of the Lollipop Chainsaw playthrough. There's only going to be two of these. The first one, which is going to be dealing with everything that can be found in Juliet's room. The second one, which is going to deal with everything that you can get in the sort of menu within the game, and also show off the bad ending. So, quite a lot to cover. And the first thing that we'll show off is the difficulty. So you've got easy, which is obviously a chicken difficulty, normal, which is what I've been playing on, hard, and then very hard, which I think probably is very hard, but eh. So here we are with Juliet's room. Throughout the game you can pick up lots of concept art. So you've got all characters and all sorts, there's all bits of information to do with the characters as well that you can see on when like they're first introduced, but that's kind of about it. I do wish that there was a slightly easier way of getting through half of this concept art, but it's all that I can do really. You can also see all of the name zombies that you've killed, all the lollipop flavours that you've gotten, all of the costumes that you can either unlock or purchase throughout the game. You can also listen to the phone messages that you pick up throughout the game. I can't remember exactly how it is that you listen to some of them, because I think the phone will ring at certain points during the game and you have to select or something ridiculous like that to be able to listen to them to get them all, but I've got them all so you get to hear all of them. Some of them are quite funny, some of them are a bit ridiculous. I can't remember whether there's anything else that we'd be looking at in this particular part, but oh yes, that's it. Achievements! Which is what I'm going to spend most of this bit talking about, because concept art, love it, but obviously we are also hearing Cherry Bomb, so I kind of need to keep talking. So there are a total of 50 achievements in Lollipop Chainsaw, or 50 trophies, whatever. So you've got Zombie Hunter Apprentice, which is very easy to get, just buy a combo at chop2shop.zom and use it, very simple. Unclean and Uncool, which is just defeated Hazmat in the prologue. Zed's Dead Baby, Zed's Dead, just defeated Zed. Viking Metal Rules, defeated Vic. Dirty Hippie, defeated Mariska. Disco's Dead, defeated Josie. Leapfrog Girl, leapfrogged 10 times in a row. That's quite a challenge. I swear I did it by mistake! Which is peeping under Juliet's skirt once. Essentially you spin the camera down and she will put a hand to prevent you from looking, and I think essentially you kind of just have to hold it there for a while and then eventually you'll get a peek. It's a disgusting one. You're just like, ew. Absolutely vile. You feel dirty for doing it, but it's an easy achievement. Endorsed by Cordelia, get 30 headshots. Sparkle Hunting Master, succeed in 7 zombie sparkle hunting. Gunstruck, spelt G-U-N-N, clever, struck by lightning 10 times, which would be in stage 2. Super Shopper, spend 10,000 medals at chop2shop.zom. Love Nick, kiss Nick 100 times, i.e. use 100 Nick tickets. Juliet 51, 51 successful dropkicks, obviously a reference to Suda 51. International Zombie Hunter, registered in world leaderboards for all stages, because obviously there's a leaderboard thing in this game, which you can upload to, but eh, who cares. Groovy Hunter, kill 500 zombies. Zombie Slayer, kill 3,000 zombies. Rich Hunter, pick up 1,000 zombie medals. Millionaire Hunter, pick up 10,000 zombie medals. San Romero Knight's Savior, rescued all classmates. Lollipop Addict, collected all lollipop wrappers. Always on the phone, collected all telephone messages. Zombie Fancier, completed the zombie album. With that, some zombies are specific to the harder difficulties. Not many, but some. So if you want to get all of the named zombies, that's what you're going to have to do. You're going to have to play it on multiple difficulties. That's it. OMG, music is so cool. Collected all the background music. Perfect body. You completely level up Juliet, which I did in this playthrough. Master Sushi Chef. Collected all combos. Watch out for the balls. Dodge and counter Zed's electric balls 15 times. Cheerleader overboard. Succeeded in the quick time event at the edge of Veek's ship. Third Eye, dodge all balloon attacks in the Mariska battle. Critical UFO finish, Funk Josie in the last 10 seconds. Elephant Tamer, counter Lewis's attack 10 times. Fingered, cut off 20 fingers during the Killerbilly fight. Lifeguard, rescued all classmates in the prologue. Accidental Vandalism, destroyed 300 objects in the game. Go Medal Racer, go! Pick up all the zombie medals on the rooftop with Chainsaw Dash during Chapter 2, or Stage 2. Legendary Harvester, harvested all the crops in the first field with Combine in Stage 3. Obviously we did that. No Fear of Heights, beat the gondola game without shooting, so that's the one climbing up the tower. How you do that, I have no idea. Little Sisters are the worst. Don't get hit by Rosalind's Wrecking Ball. Quite easy. Aced Auto Shop class, clear all the kill car cuties in a row in the Killerbilly fight. Or stage 6 to be more precise. And then we have Noob Zombie Hunter, clear stage 1 surpassing dad's score. Beginner Zombie Hunter, clear stage 1 surpassing dad's score. Intermediate Zombie Hunter, clear stage 2 surpassing dad's score. Advanced Zombie Hunter, clear stage 3 surpassing dad's score. Super Zombie Hunter, clear stage 4 surpassing dad's score. Excellent Zombie Hunter, clear stage 5 surpassing dad's score. Master Zombie Hunter, clear stage 6 surpassing dad's score. Congratulations, happy birthday for watching the happy ending. Horrid birthday. Watch the bad ending. And last but not least, we have Rock and Roll Isn't Here Anymore, defeated Lewis Legend, and I Came, I Saw, I Kicked Its Ass, for defeating Killerbilly. So, yes. Now, I have to say I'm quite impressed with my collection total, because 88% is not bad. I mean, it's quite fitting, I feel, because I love a bit of Back to the Future, so 88 miles per hour! Woo! But this covers basically everything you can possibly collect in the game, from the background music to all that jazz. And actually, if you wanted the specifics of where songs turn up in the levels, you can tell in here because of the little code at the end. So like Psych 5, Psych 6, basically that says what level they're from. So Psych is Mariska, and you get the gist. And I believe I have every single main song within the levels, which makes me very happy. But I don't have every single song total. Oh, okay, so Burning Pompadour Zombie was that, as was... Oh, okay, so Rock just continues all through until you get Zombie Burger for Killerbilly. Fair enough. So this is the Zombie Collection. We get information about these zombies, so I don't know quite how you'd be born with three testes, but there you go. And some of these are actually really quite funny. These do make me smile. Because I hadn't actually looked at them all properly, but... Jumbawumba, I get knocked down, but I get up again, you ain't never gonna beat me down. Love a bit of tub thumping. And... ew. Totally fine with a bit of dermatology, but not that, and... more information than I needed to know, but at least it's a narration rather than someone telling me with a voice. And okay, someone had a crush on Gideon. And oh my god, Fitzgibbon was a furry. Oh! And if you're wondering where the art and stuff for the Dark Purveyors is, it's all in here because they're classified as named zombies. And yeah, it's quite cool. Now let's see about Paul here, and I mean, to be fair, if you're wearing short shorts, it's always the risky run, but you see, that's why you store things quite well. And fair enough. So, fat old woman, lovely. And it's the type of thing that makes you just go, I want to vomit in my mouth slightly. And God, what a bitch. Makes you wonder whether that actually managed to succeed or not, but eh. And lovely, he's influenced by necrophilia. Ugh. But yeah, really, it's only in that side view that you actually get to see that Vika has an actually larger build and... Ew, he photoshopped, ugh. I quite like that one. That one's quite fun, and it's fascinating how young Mariska looks in some of her concept art. Like there, she looks a lot younger than she appears in the actual game, which is fascinating. And Zombie Geek Man. And God, has Game of Thrones really been going for that long? Like, obviously, I mean, the book's been out for bloody forever, but it's astounding. Right, so, yeah, Jesus wept. Because obviously, Lollipop Chainsaw came out in 2012, at which point Game of Thrones had been out for about a year at that point. So, it's like, wow. That was a timely reference that I didn't know. And so for a rock and roller, he was a bit nuts. And oh, how ironic. And yep, that sounds about right for, for certain radical Christians, I feel. And that mech is still glorious! I do really like Lewis Legend's concept art, it's great, and what's fascinating is that, oh, influences M. Night Shyamalan. Perfect. But yeah, you could really see the Elvis in there. And I don't know where these extra zombies are, but eh. And here we go. So this is the list of achievements. Obviously, I've already gone through this list to show you things. So you'll get to see all the icons of the ones that I've actually unlocked, but I've only done 60% of the achievements, because some of them are difficult. But some of them, as I said, actually quite easy. And I do like it when games show you the achievements that you unlock in the game, because that way, you like in this instance, I don't have to go out of the game into like the Xbox menu to show you these things, because I'm just not going to do that, because that would just look really messy. But because this is in-game, I can actually show it off, and that's quite glorious. And makes me feel a lot better, because it means that I can show stuff off. And this is hilarious. I've got beginner zombie hunter, and excellent zombie hunter, and master zombie hunter, but I don't have any of the others. Which is just ridiculous. I'm flabbergasted by it, really. Like, it doesn't make sense in my head. And I don't quite know, like, to get all the lollipop wrappers, you must just have to pick up every lollipop in the game on multiple difficulties. It must be the multiple difficulties thing, because that's the only way that certain zombies turn up, so it must be the way that only certain lollipops show up as well. Which I suppose would sort of make sense, because if you did the first four, were like the prologue, the next four, or whatever, were stage one, it varies. But anyway, it's time to go into the telephone messages. So some of these you will pick up in those random little segments, and they're quite funny. Others you do have to actively find and listen to.
Hey baby, it's Mom. I just wanted to check that your boyfriend's still coming.
But,
to meet him.
Yeah, so basically what happens is whenever you get one of those jingles, you have to press... You have to go into this menu and listen. So basically you're just waiting for the
Where are you?
Ding 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 ding. So yeah, it's an awkward one, because really it feels like you should be answering the phone, but obviously they're voice messages. So, whenever that you... Because obviously, I think during stage 6, you did see the little phone icon turn up and hear the little jingle, but... Yeah, that didn't quite... It doesn't quite compute that go to your telephone messages because you've unlocked something. It doesn't come up there. But yes... Juliet's mom really, really does like phoning.
Love you, sweetness. Juliet, it's Mom. I hate to be a dingbat, but I guess I forgot to buy milk and I have to make your cake. Would you mind picking some up on the way? Wait. I really am a dingbat. It's sitting right here on the counter.
Now, I know I did do a little talk over about Juliet's mum, but I don't know whether I did her voice actress. If I did, great. If not, I'm just going to do that now, and then we are fully sorted. So, Elizabeth Starling is voiced by Vanessa Marshall, who,
I'll get back to you as soon as possible.
Trying to see what she'd most likely be recognized as. So,
listen. Are you thinking about
she's voiced Wonder Woman in Justice League Crisis on Two Earths and Justice League The Flashpoint Paradox. She's also voiced Poison Ivy in numerous Batman things. She's mostly done... She's done quite a lot of video game work.
Okay.
So, she is the voice of Nala in Kingdom Hearts 2, Poison Ivy and Catwoman in Lego Batman the video game. She's Olga Gurlikovich in Metal Gear Solid 2, Eva in Metal Gear Solid Portable Ops, Strangelove in Metal Gear Solid Peace Walker and Phantom Pain, Dr. Naomi in No More Heroes. She's the voice of Dr. Nefarious' computer, and Pepper Fairbanks in Ratchet & Clank Future, A Crack in Time. She does the voice for the Wicked Witch, Cinderella and Grandma in Shrek 2, the video game, which I did actually play. She's also Miss Bloody Rachel in Beautiful Joe 2. And she's Crystal Frost / Killer Frost in Young Justice Legacy. She also does the voice of Nani in Lilo & Stitch Trouble in Paradise. And that's probably most of the main things, I feel. So nothing hugely noticeable that most people would pay attention to. But still, she's quite awesome and does a reasonable amount of stuff. And oh, Rosalind. And ah, the voicemail messages. Something I found quite funny is because I, now that I work in an office, I have had to set an out of office message or unavailable message. It's one of the most awkward things ever. Because you're just like, right, what do I say? Hello, this is Richard. You have gotten through to blah 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 blah. Unfortunately, I'm not available right now. Please leave a message, and I will get back to you as soon as possible. It's just like, oh, it's just sitting down to do it. It's just so awkward.
It's Dad. Juliet, get used to dodging. You want to be a master zombie hunter, you gotta dodge.
But we are basically, I think, right at the end of... Yes, here we go. Voicemail 21. Dag blasted voicemail.
Voicemail, so please call me back later. Over.
So there we go, that is everything in Juliet's room that we can possibly have a look at, and so now we're just going to go into the start menu. This is what it looks like. Obviously you can select, this is what I've been doing, but obviously I wanted to hide the fact that Killer Billy was there. You can go into ranking mode, as if we're going to do that. And if you go to Juliet's house, you can have a look in Juliet's room. You can also go into costumes, which is what we're going to do here. So, I'm going to look at all the ones that I've unlocked. I should point out that there are a bunch of anime-specific outfits that we can lock, well, unlock or buy. I bought some of them, but they were actually all included in the Japanese version as DLC. But they were just available in the regular game in the West. So, you have Shiro from Dead Man Wonderland, Chifusa Manyu from Manyu Hikenjo, which is Magical Breast's Secret Sword Scroll, Rei Miyamoto from High School of the Dead, Seiko Busujima from High School of the Dead, and then Haruna from Kore wa Zombie Desukan, which is this a zombie? Which is quite hilarious, from what I've seen, anyway. Obviously, there are ones that I haven't unlocked yet. You can get Cordelia's costume, Rosalind's costume, Dad's costume for beating stages 2, 3, 4, and 5, as so on. And there's a few that were DLC, but either way, we're going to go and do... Well, you're going to see a cutscene, and then we're going to do the final extras in the next part. So, I shall see you then.